Hello folks, welcome back to Epic Battle Fantasy 4. Last episode I didn't take on this fight to get this chest. Yeah, let's do that. Well, that was a good freeze. Didn't quite kill him. Okay, fair enough. Instant death, that was what I was hoping for. Yeah, let's just keep using that. Yeah, that is a physical attack, just its base power is so low, that's why it did so little. I was wondering that. Now just a second. There we go. What are it sitting up in the background? Because yeah, today is the 4th of February. Yesterday, the 3rd of February, the preload for XCOM 2 was released. So I'm preloading it right now. It's at 57%. This woman here, collect the eggs for her because she will give you something that is pretty crucial to beating bosses on epic difficulty later on. For example, there is one boss that you face one of the four at a time and then two of the four in consecutive waves. So like there's one, two, and then the next wave there's another two of them. I'm not gonna say who they are because spoilers. Facing them on epic difficulty, they can destroy you in one shot. Oh great, another different flower. It can heal, so. Oh yeah, I forgot he takes no damage from light. Can you stop healing him, please? You're doing nothing but prolonging his death. Yeah, just trimming the hedge with the legend. Let's see. We should save up the 7,000 for that. Matt. We should probably save up 12,000. Nets, how much do you have? Not much. Yeah, let's get clients. Any of my main weapons that could be upgraded? Yeah, I'll go with that. That's already fully upgraded, so I suppose I'll upgrade that for resistance to the main elements. Nothing else, so yeah. The Trojan horse. I believe that's what it's called anyway. Might be wrong. So I believe that's what it's called in Epic Battle Fantasy 3. Now it's called the Horse Fort. Fair enough. No. Move to backup. No. Get the spaceman in. Get rid of that. Thank you very much. And we'll hit him again, get him up to 9 poison. Oh yeah, randomly cast scan bot. I've only got that armor on because it's pretty, you know, durable, so. Thank you. serves you right for summoning that slime. Oh yeah, your accuracy was lowered because of your armor. Yeah, that defense is why I've got that on him. Well, I suppose you could have the woolly mammoth summon, so. Yeah, or I suppose the cowboy shark. Speckled egg, ham, and bacon. So you're gonna have to save some of that lovely, lovely ham that increases your attack by 2%. It is worth it. Wait, why is wood weak to electricity? I've only now just wondered that, but... Well, it's a game, so it doesn't really matter. More plastic and a gun. What was that again? The Vortex Cannon, made of spell targets. Boost the power of wind skills and may cast shockwave with certain skills. Not bad. That poison. It will be handy. It also got rid of the cat's shields, so that's good. Thank you. You know what I feel like doing? Just for fun. That is his one useful limit break. I say his because after playing Epic Battle Fantasy 3, to me it's only right that it's his. I wasn't gonna say it, but I suppose I will. The Horn of Gondor! It boosts their morale. Can't remember if that's a reference to the actual films or if that's just a reference to another YouTuber who also done this game at one point. It's not a wise idea to leave them with attack buffs and everything. But I'm being ballsy, so. Stagger. Oh, what are you weak to again? Eh, screw it. It would have been so funny if that had killed him. Because poison gas is not meant for killing itself. It's meant for poisoning. Lance, how can a bug fly into your mouth when you've got a gas mask on? Just a little flaw in your logic there, Lance. We don't actually have to cross this, thankfully. Until my health regenerates. I did get some skills, you know, upgraded revive, upgraded tank guns, that's pretty much what I've done. Yeah, tank guns now does about 250 damage, which is not bad. Yeah, let's see what this does. Not bad. Now, you heal yourself. As of right now, 20 minutes into recording, XCOM 2 is now up to 65%. And it's going at 2 megabytes per second. It's not bad, even while recording. Well, being honest, I don't think the recording has too much of an effect on it, because this game doesn't use the internet at all, so. Ah, darn it. Gas mask is gonna make this battle harder because it's gonna be poisoning them while I'm trying to kill them. Because these are one of the guys that poison actually heals. And it was the same in Epic Battle Fantasy 3 on Epic difficulty. So, yeah. It's not much healing, but it's still healing. I'm gonna be mean and just airstrike this one dude. But yeah, my internet should be a bit faster now, because apparently there was some error that was going on. And yeah, it's been fixed, but yeah, pick up this egg. So we've got to start buffing iron, but oh well. Yeah, I don't see none of you. I think we've healed up enough now. One enemy we haven't seen here. The river squid. Wait, Nats just dodged rain. She actually physically dodged rain. That's how much dodge she's got right now. Or evasiveness. Dang, girl. Okay, we'll use this to buff ourselves, I suppose. Get that accuracy lower off of you. And buff your attack back up. Heal up. How much do you do against them? Yeah, fair enough. Wow, you just really hate Lance. What did he do to you? Cleanse that curse off of him. Heal yourself, yeah. And you know what? Temper Lance. I believe this does affect his tank guns and all that good stuff. 12,000. And then 666, of course. Alright. Not 50, 500 to 600 damage on a crit 8 times. That's a lot of damage. That buffing was worth it. I might as well. I don't think that did any extra damage. Now, in fact, what's up this way? Is there a chest I can grab? No. Up that bit there lies the boss, but we cannot get there just yet. And oh, we do have one more battle before we get to the mini boss. Is there anyone that can learn the skill I was wanting? Yep, you can learn Protect. No, you can't really learn anything I want. Well, I suppose Heal more, yes. And Tanks. Four wave battle. This is gonna take a bit. You deserve that. Of course, his friend saw that. So, Anna, out. Lance, would you do me a favor? Would you somehow dispel his guard? See? Now, Lance, Back you go. Alright, let's see what kind of debuffs you can put on them. Burn, dispel, not bad. Yeah, those flowers, they need to go. Let's get up to 70 defense. That's why I got that. And yeah. Okay, that thing is stunned, so it's not going to be doing too much now. Yeah, because Matt's got Curse on him, he loses 10 that defense up per turn, so. Aw, what a cute little guy. He's gonna die. Oh, there's one we haven't gone yet. Freeze, that's good, that means they'll be immobile. You ass. Of course you would. Good, got rid of the healing one. Yeah, do that. Yeah, I've got a lot of pineapples, just toss one out. Oh, you're an asshole. Can you stop summoning, please? There we go. Perfect. Thank you. And there we go. I'm actually gonna switch up Nats's thing. That does provide a bit of evade. I'd rather have a bit of defense. Can any of my main weapons be upgraded? Ooh. The Sapphire Giant. Yes, please. Nothing else to upgrade. Final check of the skills of the episode. Oh, really? We're so close as well. In fact, let's summon Scanbot and then run. Alright. I'm probably gonna regret this, but I'm gonna try it on epic difficulty. So yeah. Don't see a non-UR one. And I will equip Lance with the thing again, more defense. Let's go. Yeah, you still only got your two limit breaks here. I suppose we'll go and bless ourselves. Temper. And I suppose this. Yeah, he hurts. Anna died because she has low health. Matt almost died because he's still kind of weak to fire. I was gonna switch in Lance anyway, so. Now, Lance, if you'd be so kind as to lower his defense, 50% chance to fail, and we didn't get it. Compared to this, yeah. But wait, was he weak to water? He was weak to water. Yeah, Sapphire Giant, go. Lance, you have one more chance to do this. Nice. Let's see the damage. Freaking hell! You saw it here. That's how overpowered Matt-Lance can be on epic difficulty, you know, fully buffed and everything. It is possible to take out bosses in one turn, if you don't count the thunderstorm I did at the start. That was kind of anticlimactic. Problem is though, you do need a couple turns to set it up, and by that time if you haven't buffed your defensive capabilities, you could be dead. And we got some chili sauce. That really was an anticlimactic boss fight. Oh well, back to normal for next episode. And get you out of that. I think that was very well worth it. Yeah, what's his attack? 379. Thing is, though, most things here are, you know, they're either immune or will absorb water. So yeah, that was a pretty, like, well, for the third time, anticlimactic boss fight. So yeah, I suppose, nah, I won't upgrade that. And Matt, you could have done even more damage. You see, if I had went to the shock sword, I wouldn't have taken him in one shot, because that geyser attack at the end of that combo, that was crucial to defeating him. That's what actually defeated him. So yeah. This has been the Scottish Boy 112, signing out. Jack-O-Lantern got wrecked.